It's nice to be here. It's nice to be here. I cannot blame myself to be in the presence of God. Why? Because I'm very happy. Even I'm not here, you know, my heart is very painful. That I'm losing the things from above. I'm losing. You know, to be in the presence of God is very much important. I can have everything, but without Jesus, I cannot do anything. You can manage millions, but without Jesus, you are nothing. You are nothing. You are lost. Because you must spend much time in the presence of God. Why? In Jesus, there is life. In Jesus, there is prosperity. In Jesus, it's beautiful. To be in the presence of God is very beautiful. Where will be without Him? Just imagine. Where we'll be without Him? Hey! People, they can discourage in you. They can talk the way they want. But Jesus, through your giving, if you are devoted to the things of God, He will salute you. He will reward you. He will never leave you. He will never leave you. Why? Because He's highly, 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 the Most High God. The creator of anything in the world. That is why we must spend much time to speak about Him. Don't undermine yourself. You are so much important. You are so much important. Because God, He made you in His own image. Because you are the image of God. Why are you supposed to undermine yourself? Why are you supposed to undermine yourself? My brother, let me tell you something. You will make it in life. You will make it in life. Don't rid yourself off. God is the time now to prepare the table before your enemy. That is why I like to say goodness and mercy will follow you all the days of your life. You continue to give unto God. Continue to serve in the Lord. No matter you didn't eat anything. But God, He's watching at you. He will never leave you. I'm not talking what I don't know. If you spend much time to serve God, He will provide. Why? It's God. He's the creator of anything in the world. But you won't make it.
People will say, and they will say you won't make it. They will judge you. They will say you will be shy.
But you will never die there. You will never die there.
Hallelujah.
You will never die the place where you stay now. There you are still got somewhere. Through your giving. Through working in the things of God. Through participating. Through submission.
Hallelujah.
When you submit to the things of God, God never leave you. Continue to submit yourself to do the things of God. You will see the big things. Because some of you, the place where you are, you are not supposed to be there. But keep on believing. Because faith comes by hearing.
Hallelujah.
Hearing the word of God. Today I'm here to preach for you. That you must continue to give. You must continue to tithe. Because we want to go to cathedral.
You will see our evangelists running the way you are not expecting. But we can do it through your prayer. We cannot do anything without the prayer and the fasting. We want to reach
24,000 seater cathedral.
It's not a joke.
As a joke.
It's going to pass. Mark that word. It's going to pass. That is why I say the evangelist of the His Will Worship Center, through the support of our mother, we will make it. No matter devil like or not, woman of God, we are still go far. No matter people, they can talk the way they want, but we are still go far. No matter they can criticize. I don't talk what I don't know.
I'm
a testimony.
The
God of His Will Worship Center. He
takes
me from nowhere. When you see me, see the blessing. See the beneficiary of
this
Jesus.
Yes, oh Christ.
Of His Will Worship Center.
Wow, no, His Will
Worship. He's alive, my brother.
We are chill.
Just continue to believe in. Continue to serve in the Lord. Let me go to the theme of today. Prosperity. And finances. Prosperity. And finances. Why evangelists say prosperity and finances? Everyone, you want to prosper. How can you prosper without the word of God? How can you prosper without giving? Don't be selfish. It is possible. You can give everything that you have. God will provide. There is no one who continue to give without reward. Yes, from today, in your business, continue to give. Let's quickly read the word of God. From Luke 6:28. Everyone, I request you to read the Bible, to listen what the Bible says. Oh, thank you, Jesus.
We are going to read in the book of Luke, chapter 6, verse 28 in NIV. It says, bless those who curse you. Pray for those who hate you.
Luke 6, chapter 6, verse 38.
Verse 38.
Yes.
Luke chapter 6, verse 38. It says, give,
yes,
and you will receive. Your gift will return to you in full, pressed down, shaken together to make room for more, running over, poured into your lap. The amount you give will determine the amount you get back.
It's not me, it's the Bible.
The
Bible says, give, it will be given unto you. A good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, you will pour into lamp for with the measure you give. The measure you give is how you are going to receive. When you continue to give in the presence of God, you will never lose anything. There you will never lose anything. No matter you don't have. Maybe you tell yourself that evangelist, because I'm not working, I'm going to use what to give. To work in the presence of God. It's a set of something that you said you are giving. You volunteer to work in the presence of God. No matter the situation,
Maybe you think that maybe you don't have much time. Give yourself time to do the things of God. God, he will reward you. Because God, he loves us all. He is watching us wherever we are going. My brother is watching you. He's watching you. He loves you so much. Through your giving, if you want to prosper, if you want to see breakthrough, yes, from today, try to give. Do something that you didn't do it before. If you want to change your life, thank God by giving. If you want to destroy the prince of darkness, continue to give in the presence of God. Prosperity and finances. Pastor, evangelist, I want to prosper, but I'm not giving in the presence of God. How are you going to prosper? Because you are so selfish. But if you try to give whatever you have, God, he will provide. Because he is the creator of anything in the world. Why? You see many people every month testifying about the grace of God, about the wonderful of God. If you watch those people, they are giving without complaining, and God will reward you.
Mazalani,
go
starting banal over the sanctuary or chalete ya chalete.
There at the street, they say money goes to money.
It's not like that. But those who have money,
but
that those that they continue to give, that is why you are not seeing them struggling. You know Pastor Lazarus, he was a giver. Given people without asking. Why? Seeing that man prospering, he was giving without complaining. Even you today, continue to give whatever you have. You will see the breakthrough. Give in the presence of God through your offering. The evangelist now from
Zimbabwe,
without your giving, they cannot go there. They cannot pray by tongue. Say, we want to go there. They cannot walk. Say, we want to go to Zimbabwe. But through your offering, with all your heart, God, he will provide. I don't know why today I come with this. You know the things of God operating in a special way. Because early in the morning, around past 3, I wake up. I was praying. Because sometimes if I'm going to preach, I'm not sleeping. Even yesterday, I was evangelizing around Alexander, preaching the gospel of Jesus. I want to see him operating. It's how I give myself to him. It's how I want to see him operating in a special way. Give yourself unto God. And do not worry about tomorrow. Don't worry about tomorrow. God, you will bless you. Father, help us.
Mudzimu kavarituse.
Help us, Jesus.
Kavarituse Yesu Christ.
Father, help us, Lord.
Mudzimu kavarituse.
Help us, Jesus.
Kavarituse Yesu Christ.
Help us, God.
Kavarituse mudzimu.
Help us, Jesus.
Kavarituse Yesu.
Help us, God.
Kavarituse mudzimu.
Help us, Lord. Help us, Lord. This is the power from above. Father, the seed that we are going to plant in His will worship center. We want a permanent seed. We want to be faithful by giving. Help us, Lord.
Mudzimu kavarituse.
Help us, Jesus.
Yeso Christo kavarituse.
Help us, Lord.
Murena kavarituse.
May see, Lord Jesus.
Kavarifele butungu Yesu.
May see, Lord Jesus.
Kavarifele butungu murena.
May see, Lord Jesus.
Kavarifele butungu mudzimu.
Lord Jesus. You know the things of God sometimes operating in a special way. God can talk to any one of you. You must have the ear to listen to the things of God. You must have the ear to listen to the voice of God. You will see the breakthrough. And we don't want to plant. We don't want to sow. The place where we cannot harvest. Imagine when you plant here. You think seed can germinate here. Here. At the carpet. Planting here. You think here there is organic matter. There is no organic matter here. There is not even a topsoil here. We want to plant in a clay soil. Woman of God, why we spend much time planting in a clay soil? It's because clay soil absorb more water than sandy soil. We cannot plant using a sandy soil. Sandy soil reflect and it cannot hold the water. Sandy soil, there is no any organic matter, but clay soil is rich. That is why if you continue to plant, mango qualify. Banana qualify.
The banana na zone zia fanele.
Why?
Dingani.
Clay soil.
Mavono na ho.
It's rich.
Opfuma.
My sister.
Karazi anga.
My brother.
Mukoma na wanga.
Wash out.
Kabala belese.
Where you are where you are sowing the seed.
Kaba thokomele une makotaba one mbeu yako.
Where you sowing your seed.
Une makotaba one
mbeu yako. Be careful.
Kaba thokomele.
The place where you sent you plow the seed.
Pethu une bataba one mbeu yako.
Don't plow anywhere.
Be
careful. If you want to see your breakthrough, or prosperity and finances, winning in that, be careful. The place where you sow this. Be careful, my brother. Be careful, daddy. Are you spending much time to sow where? My sister, are you spending time your seat where? My brother, are you spending time to plant your seat where? But if you want to destroy the curse of leg, give unto God. When we go to Philippians chapter 4, verse 17. It says, do not worry about anything, and stand praying about everything, and tell God what you need. Tell God what you need. Tell God what you need. If I spend much time to tell God what I want, He will never disappoint me. He will never leave me. The more I continue to give, He will bless me. He will bless me. He will bless me. He will bless me. My brother,
Mukomana wanga,
there at the back, the usher. Come close here. Come close. I want to show you the importance of giving. That there is power. If you want to break the yoke of darkness, God, He will bless you. If you spend much time to do the things of God, He will provide. My brother, I have something for you. It's what you deserve. It's what you deserve. It's what you deserve. Why? You spend much time to do the things of God. God, He loves you so much. He wants to promote you.
Praise the Lord.
I don't know why I'm doing this to you. Jesus loves you. You are so much important. Don't lose hope. This is not less than 100 rand. It's more than
100 rand.
Continue to do the things of God. He loves you so much. If you continue to do the things of God, it's a time of giving. The more you give, the measure you give, you will receive what you plant. What you sow, you will harvest. Hey, you will harvest. Remember, be careful. The place where you harvest and the place where you plant the seed. If you want to test God, you know, early in the morning, I was saying, God, I need to give. But I don't know. What is the name of the person? I don't know. But my first option is to give our pastor. Or because it's a women's month. Can I honor my pastor doing that? But I didn't inquire. Because sometimes we have to honor our pastor. Maybe you will see that to submit in your senior pastor is It's a waste of time.
Maybe
my brother, it's not wasting of time. It's not wasting of time. Maybe to take the chair for our pastor, you think that is a waste of time. I told you last, you sow the place where you harvest.
But I'm not saying you must go close to the pastor because you have it, you want to harvest.
No.
Do something with all your heart.
Not to impress. And a God, He will reward you. Because He's the creator of everything in the world. Do something with all your heart. When you do something in all your heart, God, He will reward you. When you spend much time to honor our pastor, to humble ourselves before him, it's not wasting of time. How can you be successful without warning your senior pastor? But if I humble myself before our pastor, God will reward me. If I submit under our senior pastor, God will reward. Because He's watching. If I want to see the evangelism growing, I need to submit. I need to listen. My pastor.
It's
my pastor. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise
the It's
Lord.
Very, very much important to submit. How can you be successful without submitting to your mother, to your father? How can you can be successful without submission? If you want to see breakthrough in your finances, submit. No matter you have, no matter you don't have, submit. You will be successful. Submit yourself to God. Woman of God, our pastor, they are called by Jesus Christ. So, it's our leader also. We need to listen. Because he is hearing from above. If we fail to listen to him, how can we listen to God? You cannot listen to God if you fail to listen to the woman of God. You cannot listen to God if you fail to pray for woman of God through your giving. Don't forget her. She deserves the best. Through your prayer, no matter you don't have money to give her, through your prayer every day, when you spend much time to praise God, say, God, we thank you for our pastor. We thank you because our pastor is still leading us.
That she meet
through your prayer. Stop gossiping. Stop gossiping. Because gossip cannot give you anything. Tell your neighbor.
vhudze o dzula
tshinavho
uri arali sa phanda na u sola
u fasika syllabus
vho tsanga kha syllabus.
We are going forward.
Require panda.
If you continue to gossip,
you are
on,
you are
on a lower level.
On a lower level.
Amen. But because we are the children of God, we need to continue to pray for our pastor.
God, He will reward us. God. He will bless us. Through giving, He will bless us. Through working, He will bless us. Through working, He will bless us. Some of you, you live without cleaning your house, running to the things of God. No, don't take it in otherwise. Take it in a good way. To run to the to cling in the presence of God. Because God, look inside. People, look outside appearance. When God washing at you, He will reward you through running to clean the things of God. Doing the things of God. God, He will bless you. Remember, be careful where you sow the seed. Remember where you sow your seed. 2 Corinthians chapter 9 verse 8. I'm about to close.
2 Corinthians chapter 9 verse
chapter 9 verse 8.
2 Corinthians chapter 9 verse 8. Yes. It says, "And God will generously provide all your need. Then you will always have everything you need and plenty left over to share with others."
It's not me, it's the Bible. God will generously provide all your need, that you will always have everything you need. You know, when you spend too much time to give, you will lack anything. God, He will give you everything that you need. You will never lack everything. You know,
hunger,
it's a shame.
Hunger is a disappointment
to God.
To God.
When God sees shame, He knows that He died for us on the cross. And emphasize the words that is finished. And it is finished. You must understand the word that is it is finished. It is finished. It is finished. Why are you complaining? To break the yoke of financial problem. Yes, from today, give unto God. Give unto God. If you want to destroy the things of devil, give unto God. He will provide.
Our God
is not a poor God.
Asimudzimu achishai.
You know, yesterday,
Murova,
utabari evangelist afelele, uphela yena lidithaba.
You will say evangelist does not lack words. He is always having something to say.
That man, when I come back Alexander evangelizing,
musi ndichibva Alexander ndichikobva uchumaira.
That man,
hola munna,
we were traveling using the taxi.
Robert Chikoshumisa taxi.
Inside the taxi.
Ngangomu taxi ni.
That man.
Oyo munna.
Ove aopela the song says.
Oba kwemba luimbo lwa uri.
Nake a sokola.
I am starving.
Ntlwele nkele so.
I am suffering. Leave me like this.
Why len seche mrao?
Why are you following me?
You know, sometimes when the taxi is quiet.
Imagine
when the man started to sing in the inside of the taxi.
You know, we
are just wondering. But I listened to that man singing that song. I'm suffering.
He said, leave me.
Why in search of me?
Why are you following me? Leave me.
Why are you following me? But is the song, I think is the song that this man knows. He knows, because you cannot just sing any song that you don't understand. But according to my understanding, I say this man, if he can know and realize that God made him in his own image, that God want to prosper him, he will sing the wonderful song that I'm highly favored, that I'm blessed, I'm not poor. You know, sometimes when you listen to the song, be careful. You know, there is the song that I rejected. Because me, I'm not growing up liking the things that. No, no matter on my time, without even money.
I never thought of peering my ears. My life. It was not in a confusing way.
And I thank God for that. I thank Jesus. That is why, when I listen to that man,
I
say, this man, he must realize the power of Jesus. And he will never sing this song. My brother, my sister, you are not cheap. You are not cheap. No matter the situation, the things not go well, but one day, through giving, he will provide. The God of his will worship center is a marvelous God. The way he provides to evangelists, the way he provides to me, he will provide to you. He will never leave you. Hey, no matter people, they can say, Ujonoka. But God, he will provide, because he is a marvelous God. He is a God of Hebrews. He's a God of Hebrews 12:29. Our God. He's a consuming fire. God. He said, do not worry about tomorrow. Tomorrow, don't worry about itself. Because we are highly, favored. We are highly 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 favored.
We are highly favored.
His will is growing.
His will is growing.
Lion will produce lion.
Ndau ito vele zandau.
Lion will produce lion.
David offered and
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 lion will produce lion.
David offered
and lion will produce lion. David will produce lion.
David offered and
lion will produce lion.
David
offered and lion will produce lion.
David offered and
lion will produce lion.
David offered
and lion will produce lion. Lion will produce lion.
David offered and
lion.
Hey. You the baby of a lion.
As a monkey.
It's not a monkey.
Get out.
It's a lion.
Hey.
The baby of a lion.
Wanawata.
The baby of a lion.
The seed
Mbeu
of pastor.
Yabafunzi.
Zachariah. Thank you, Jesus.
Joshua chapter 1, verse 8.
Yes.
It says, study this book of instruction continuously. Meditate on it day and night, so you will be sure to obey everything written in it. Only then will you prosper and succeed in all you do.
Follow me.
Kabantebele.
Follow me.
Kabantebele.
Study this book.
Kababale eno puku.
Study this book.
Kababale eno
puku. Of instruction.
Yandaela.
Continuously.
Kabai bale ba.
Meditate on it.
Kabazule kayo tuba na tuba.
Day and night.
Usiku na masiari.
When you spend much time.
Musi bachipeza
chipinga. Meditate the word of God.
Bachiko humbula
ila muzimu. What is belong to you.
Chimwe na chimwe
chini cha bachabo. Meditate the word of God. God, he will never leave you. He will surely give what is belong to you. That is what the Bible said. Study this way. Study this book of instruction. Continuously. Meditate on it. Day and night. So you will show. You will be sure. To obey everything. Writing in it. Writing in it. This book of law. When you spend much time meditating it, you will see that what? When the Bible said, give unto God. Give unto God. Submit unto God. Obey God. By giving, you will see what is belong to you. This will worship center.
His will worship center.
Listen here. God said, you are not poor. You are not poor.
When God see a suffering person, he become disappointed.
Why? The mission of Jesus in this world is to not make you to suffer. The mission of Jesus is in this world. He wants you to stay in the mansion. Put yourself down. By the things of
Let me tell you something.
That you are so much important.
That's why the Bible said
from Joshua 1:8.
Study this way.
Study this book
of instruction continuously.
And
meditate it
day
and night
so that
you will obey everything.
And
after to obey everything,
God
Himself
he will show Himself
through your giving.
God,
He will provide.
I'm
running out of
time.
Now is the time to receive. To break this
yoke.
The yoke of financial. We want to see prosperity. No lack in the children of God. The same God that He provides me to give that brother. Tomorrow, He will give you. Maybe you can find more than
10,000.
Maybe you are not believing. I'm a living testimonial. Maybe you said, how can a person give a person
10,000?
Or more than
10,000?
It's happening. Here in His will worship center.
His will worship center.
It's not a joke. That is why I say I'm a living testimony. My brother, I'm not talking what I don't know. It's happening. On me. The same God. He will provide to you. Through your giving. Everything that you have. You know sometimes. No matter you have the last amount. Give unto God. Give unto Him. Praise Him using your offering. Offering and tithe belong to God. Because Jesus said, slaver and gold belong to me. When we find money, we must return to Him. To say, Lord, I thank you. You protect me the whole month. You are working or you are not working. You see that brother. I believe that. Agasel balonja 10%.
Angasi hango visa chafumi.
Why?
Dinga.
10% belong to God.
Chafumi chindi chamuzi.
Every money that you find, no matter it can be 100 rand,
200
rand,
200 rand, 200 rand,
2000 rand,
2000 rand.
You must know that 10% belong to God. Maybe some of you, you don't know how 10% work. 100 rand. What is the 10% of 100 rand?
Chafumi cha dana ndibugai.
The 10% of 10,000?
Chafumi cha chigidi cha chigidi zofumi ndibugai.
Meaning that you know the truth.
Zishikwamba zori badiba ngo bone.
Meaning that you know the truth.
Zishikwamba zori bone badiba ngo.
Yeswabisa.
It is so shameful.
What's the man need?
To know the truth.
Where is that talent?
And you eat the money of God.
If you want to see breakthrough,
him. I'm asking you to stand up. The anointing of giving is here. The anointing of giving is here. The anointing of giving. 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 You must believe in unto him. Say, God, I want to see this anointing of prosperity and the finances. I want to see this anointing